ocean. Climb up the top.
Hi, it's the Honey Queen here, and I have a guest for Cinco de Mayo. Her roots are out of Mexico, and this is Rosana.
Hi.
And she is the best cook ever. In fact, every time we have like a get together at her house or she's bringing food, we get very excited because she really goes out and it's just always amazing. And this today you're making a lentil salad.
I am. A lentil salad. I like going to restaurants and eating, you know, all sorts of types of food, and then I like to kind of figure out how they did it. And then I like to always come home and try to figure out and then add my own touches to it. And so that's how this salad came kind of about.
Very cool.
Yeah.
We actually met her, she works at the school that my daughter goes to and my husband's the principal, but we met on some, I guess they were trips for the choir. We went on a couple trips
together.
And we got talking and then I met her at some parties we've had and things like that. And so that's why I said, hey, we need to do a YouTube, so we're doing this today. So tell us what's in here.
Well, this is a great lentil salad. It's a great vegan dish, so it's something for, you know, vegetarians and vegans out there that
very
works
popular,
very well.
Yeah.
It has, of course, lentils, green lentils you can use. There's different kinds of lentils, but I use the green ones. And you just have all fresh ingredients, as in carrots and cucumbers and celery. Some baby arugula that you can use, some cilantro, some chopped dates, and some dried sunflower seeds, which is optional if that and the dates are optional. The only thing that really is just a little bit different about is the spice za'atar, which is like a Mediterranean spice that you can find in the stores. And it adds just that little different type of flavor to it that I use. The first place that you use it actually is on pitas. You can get store-bought pitas. I just spread a little olive oil on them. You set the oven for 350 degrees and you just sprinkle a little bit of the za'atar on there. And you just heat them up so that they're a little bit crispy, not too crispy. Take them out of the oven and cut them up in wedges, and you can eat that with
the lentil. That was like about 5 or 7 minutes, right?
It's just about 5 or 7 minutes. Not really
not
a lot.
Work.
No. The lentils are what's going to take you the longest. It takes about 30 minutes. So this amount is 2/3 cup dry lentils. You just put that with twice as much water in a pot, and you let it boil. After it comes to a boil, you let it simmer for about 30 minutes. What I like to do is in that I just put a pinch of salt and I put a little bit of this in there as well.
How do you say that again?
Za'atar.
Za'atar.
Yeah.
Za'atar.
Z-A-A-T-A-R. And I just put that in while it's cooking. I also check it while it's cooking because sometimes if the water evaporates too soon, you can burn them. So I add like hot water, like maybe 2 tablespoons at a time.
Cool it down
while it's simmering, because you don't want them to burn, obviously. And then after that, you turn it off, and then you let them cool at room temperature before you start mixing them in with everything.
And I will put that recipe below and also on Pinterest.
So basically, all you do is after you have the cooled lentils, you can put those in, and it's really just tossing everything. It's about a cup of carrots. If you prefer diced, chopped carrots, I take about 2 big carrots and you dice them up, or shredded carrots, whatever you'd like. I take about 2 big stalks of celery, again, just dice them up. I take 1 big cucumber and take the skin off. And
can you do a baby?
You could.
Or a big English one, okay.
You could. And it all depends on how much vegetables you want.
I
you
love
can
vegetables.
Adjust to this. I take about maybe 1/4 cup of, and I lightly chop it. I don't.
Cilantro. You take it off the stem?
Off the stems. Okay. I use some of the stems. Stems are good.
Okay.
Everything's good. Everything's
like
edible. And then and so you just start mixing all of this up. And again, if you want more lentils, you could always increase. If you want more lentils or less vegetables, it's really up to you as far as how much of what you want. And then I put about a cup maybe of chopped dates.
All right. My dad would love this because he loves dates.
And then you just mix it up and make sure that it's all mixed up like that. And then the last thing is the baby arugula, which is takes a little doing. And all of this, oops, I'm losing some. But remember, and it's just a really nice summer dish coming into the warm
Memorial weekend.
Oh yes, and after you're done with this and after you dress it, you can put it in the refrigerator. It keeps really nice for a few days in there too.
I believe so, the 5 second rule for 10.
Oh yes, that's that's fine. And you don't, you know, it's just nice. It's nice to take somewhere. It's just nice to have if you want to.
Flavors.
Yeah. And then that's it. And I'm going to add these at the end. So now what you're going to do is in the bowl for the dressing, basically it's 2 tablespoons of olive oil and 2 tablespoons of the balsamic vinegar, about 1.5 tablespoons of the Dijon mustard.
All right.
And I need about another 1.5 tablespoons of honey.
This is honey.
Yes.
Does that look like? It slides right out because she's used something else in that.
Right. And then I always taste it. If I wanted it to be a little sweeter, you could add that. If you want it to be a little bit more balsamic, you could add that. And then I just whisk it around. And yeah. Tastes good to me.
Tastes perfect. Okay.
It could be a little sweeter, maybe. Just a little bit.
All right.
Just a little bit.
A little bit. Yeah. Yeah, I got a sweet tooth, so I always overuse
the dates also will sweeten this dish up too, so you don't want to put, you know, too much.
Yeah. All right.
And that's it.
So you're gonna pour it over there. Now, yeah.
Yeah. So I pour this here, like this, and you mix this up. And what's nice about it is you should make it probably about a good hour before you plan on serving it,
so
that it has time to set up and seep through and everything, so that it gets it. And you can have your serving dish there. That can go right at the end. And you just pour this all in.
Oh, I see. So you're going to eat it actually on top of these?
Yeah, you can use them as little garnish or eat it with it or stuff like that.
Fancy.
Yeah. So you can put that there and those go off the side.
Like that. Awesome.
And sprinkle this there. And that's really your dish.
Voila. Awesome.
So
thank you, Rosanna.
You're welcome.
Well, grandsons, granddaughter, did you find where my bee was? Right there. I always have a hidden bee for my grandchildren. Ah. And that is as be happy on top of it. So be happy. Be sure and share and like this with others. Check out me on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. I put the recipe on Pinterest. And have a great summer. This is a great way to start out. Thanks, Rosanna.
Oh, you're welcome. Thank you for having me.
Bye.